tie gon' catch me, son.
Welcome to the mob. Welcome to the mob. A lot of people told us that we wouldn't give five. Now we living life like it ain't no tomorrow. Baby, welcome to the mob.
Yo, welcome back to the Double MB Mob channel, man. Today, back with some 50 Cent. This is the ever so classic How to Rob. One of the most infamous rap records of all time. I've heard it. Dell and Dame haven't heard it.
Is it this?
No, not to nobody in particular.
Okay.
I don't know if I should let y'all hear the song and then give y'all.
Let us hear the song, see, and then something we don't understand, you'll clear it up with the.
Gotcha, okay. Oh, y'all ready?
Yeah.
Yo, you know what this is, boy, for real. The art of getting wrong. This is how we do with freestyle, boy. You know what I'm saying?
With a deal. If my record don't sell, I'ma rob and steal. You better recognize, nigga, I'm straight from the street. These industry niggas are starting to look like something to eat. I snatch Kim, tell her I wanna see her again. Then pass down to the nearest ATM. I have dreams of fucking the R&B bitch. But I wake up early and bounce with all the shit when I apply pressure. Son, it ain't even funny. I'm out to stick Bobby for some of that Whitney money. Ryan McKnight, I can get the nigga anytime. That keep sweating, staring at the barrel with my nine. Since these Harlem World niggas seem to all be fam. I put the gun to call Dan, tell him, tell your man, man, see better. I'm up off that watch now. I mean right now, the only excuse for being broke is being in jail. And the nigga can't make barely broke as hell. I rob ODB, but that'd be a waste of time. Probably have to clap him running toss to nine. I follow Fox in the drop for four blocks. Plotting the chips up for that rock, corrupt cop. What you get yourself like? 4 million, got something to live for. Don't want a nigga putting four through that Bentley coupe though. I may hand you case like Duke. Get on the ground, you ain't with Mary no more. Where you getting chips from now? I've been scheming on Tony Pope. Says they family, Steve don't have to wear that platinum shit around me. I'm a klepto, not for real, son, I'm sick. I'm about to stick slate brick for all that old school shit. Right now I'm bent, when I get like this I don't think about the next TVJ. Take off that tight ass meat, I raw pump without a gun. Snatch his piece and run, just never wait 400 pounds. I ain't gon' catch me, son.
So that's like
kind of
thing like Kendrick did. But not saying he's gonna rob me.
Right after the Grammys and Will Smith and Jada ass down in Miami. Run up on Timberland and Missy with the pound like you. Give me the cash, you put the hot dog down. I figured it out, niggas been robbing Joe before. That's why his ass don't wanna be a player no more. My attitude, I'm robbing JD, fuck you, pay me. Had to brat with him, shoulda had his gap with him. DMX wanna get down? Well, you tell on me. I'm on that trench shit, I do my dirt all by my lonely. I should rob Clue, man, this shit did well. I wanna stick TQ, but this shit ain't sell. I hit the studios, take niggas' shoes and leave. Catch Red Ghost and RZA for them funny ass rings. Tell Sticky, give me the cash for our MP3. I beat your ass like that white boy on MTV. And if it's wanna battle, I'm sticking him up. Fuck the cab, the car and it's picking him up. Heavy tried to hide his shit. Hey nigga, I saw you. He said, why you robbing me? I got nothing but love for you. Caught Jewel down, flush cash, money piece. Told him I wanted all. He said, even my gold teeth. I caught Black Street on a back street in the black Jeep. One at a time. Get out and take off your shine. Did you ever think that you would be this rich? Did you ever think that you would have these hits? Did you ever think that I'd flash the nine and walk off with your shit like it's mine? I'ma keep sticking niggas until I'm living. I brought boys to men like I'm Michael Bivens. Catch Tyson for half that cash like Robert Givens. I'm hungry for real, I'm about to stick Mr. C. That nigga still eating off Big First LP. I had busted a whole flip mode on the flow. He asked me if I had enough, I told him, give me some more. If you feeling this, then wait for the sequel. I gotta get Kirk Franklin for Robin's Lost People.
Industry, tell us how this ain't serious.
That was fire.
Did anybody reply?
Jay kind of did. He, so I gotta do the back right now. So this was before 50 was known, of course, and this was his first song that a lot of people recognized him from. Mm-hmm. And so he did it, of course, on purpose. He mentioned all these people
to get notoriety.
Right. So I think the year after, that's the year Jay-Z went on Summer Jam, and he was like, I'm about a dollar, who the fuck is 50 Cent? And so that was his reply. Ain't nobody really reply, because while 50 wasn't known for music, everybody did know him from the streets. So they knew that
he would really do that.
Right. So, but yeah, I mean, I think everybody knew what he was doing, so nobody took it like that serious. But mm-hmm. Yeah.
That was fine.
Yeah, man. One of the classic records in hip hop. Have I asked y'all what's your favorite diss record? I did. Mm-hmm. What y'all say?
Mine's 3 Miller.
Right. Okay, I do remember that. And you said what?
Gotta change it.
Sure.
Okay, it had to be the Ice Cube one.
No Vaseline?
Yeah, that was fire.
Oh, okay. No Vaseline.
Okay. That's a go. Okay. I feel like I had one more question. What y'all think about people
robbing?
No, I
thought you were about to say what you think about people taking shit. That's what you about to say?
Nah. Is that something you want to talk about?
No.
You sure? How do you feel about people robbing people?
I
was gonna ask, how do you feel about people having an approach when they're trying to get notoriety to doing stuff like this? You think it's corny? You think?
I think it's smart.
You think it's smart?
6ix9ine did. When 6ix9ine first came out, everybody said, well, who is this rainbow head ass nigga?
Oh, okay. I see what you mean. Okay, okay, okay. Okay.
What's the name?
It's still and you like that approach. You like people doing what they gotta do to get notoriety, even if it don't necessarily.
Yeah, but because there's still a lot of underground rappers out here that really don't like that approach type shit, so that's the reason why they still underground type shit. But it's like, there's still a lot of underground rappers out here that's good that don't get enough notoriety.
Okay.
Normally it takes the underground rapper to be beefing with somebody that's known, and that underground rapper killed the known person, and then that's, you can use that as notoriety. Or, you know, something like how 6ix9ine did. Everybody thought that he was a joke. Rapper with colored rainbow hair claiming blood. You know what I'm saying? So he used that as notoriety. Who else? And then some people actually, like, some rappers actually put underground rappers on, like how Meek Mill, I wouldn't say he put them on, but he had people, you know, recognize Roddy.
Okay.
That's about it.
Okay, so overall, you agree with people doing whatever they got to do to make it, even if it comes at the expense of yourself, somebody else, your morals, your ethics, your values?
No, I don't think, not to that extent. That's not crazy. It would be nice if you do the old-fashioned way, but to not. I mean, you probably could. I mean, social media is so big in the world right now. Like, you probably could get notarized from the social media. You know what I'm saying? It's only one little thing that you could do to get you notarized. Like, people, like dancing, dancers, for example. They do one thing to a certain beat or a certain song, and they get notarized for some reason like that. So there's a difference right there.
Dev, how you feel about people doing whatever they got to do to get notoriety? Something like this.
I don't mind something like this, because it's basically like you talking your shit. Basically sound better than all you niggas. Really. But in his case, he's saying, nigga, if this shit don't work out, look the fuck out, nigga. And I'm pretty sure he was probably serious. But I don't see nothing wrong with it. But if this is your, if the stuff like this is your whole gimmick all the time, I feel like you can get corny. Once you start getting corny, then it's like, all right. Now, if you can use this to boost your, you know, boost your status, okay, cool. But keep doing it, it's corny. Like, Kendrick did it once. Even, what's her name? Young Miami? She just did it. When she was saying she gonna fuck all these people and all that stuff, she just did it. So, ain't nothing wrong with it. Like you said, people not really tripping off of it. You know, you really know it's just to, you know what I'm saying, boost your shit up. So, I don't see nothing wrong. But once you start doing corny stuff and, like, you become a gimmick, then it's like, all right, bro. Like.
And what would you identify as corny? Or as, what's a gimmick that you would consider corny? They ain't brought up 6ix9ine. Do you think that was corny?
See, that's what I'm saying. Like, it was his, like, when he first started, you know, we was messing with him. And then he kept going, and then it turned into you being corny now. So, you can use that.
Okay.
Yeah, so, it's like...
What about, let's say a female rapper with, like, a Cardi B style that's not really who she is. She's just doing it for clicks.
I feel like if anybody gets exposed, if you say stuff in your music and you get exposed for and that you really don't do it, whether it's some gangster shit, whether it's some freak ass shit, I mean, pretty people gonna be like, well, you're gonna have to come with a different approach to now. We know that's cap. So now, like, if now 50 was the nigga, like how he said he gonna rob everybody, and then out of this, he got his ass robbed about 5 times. Like, nigga, you ain't robbing nobody. You just got your ass braced 5 times, nigga. Like, now we don't believe you type shit. So once people can't... See, that's what really entertainment is about. Whether it's acting, rapping, YouTube, what's the name? Because all them pranks and shit, we know that shit not really real. It's just entertainment. Once you're not believable anymore, that's when you don't... That's when your shit go down. So once you come... Once you're not believable, once you're exposed, if you're not really on that type of time, whatever you talk about... Then that's when your stock drop.
That's all I had on this one. Anything y'all want to touch?
Nah, that shit was fire though. I fuck with it. I fuck with the beat. And you said that's one of his first songs. Is that that's before he got shot?
I think it is. I think it's before he got shot. So it gotta be '98, '99. I forgot when he got shot.
For that to be his first song, that's fire.
Oh no. This is not his first song. This is the first song that
really got some buzz.
But no, 50 was putting out music on like '96, '97, '98, something like that.
Well, that is first, right? So it's a pretty good song to me. I fuck with it.
Okay. Well, as always, like, comment, subscribe. Let us know how y'all felt about the song, How to Rob. Again, a cult classic. Yeah, man. And shout out to 50. We appreciate y'all for watching. And until next time.
Welcome to the mob. A lot of people told us that we wouldn't get fired. Now we